But I appreciate the opportunity to be here to talk about this, and I think the first thing that you're talking about there is about initiatives to build a productive workforce. I basically think when you think about productivity, there are a number of elements that are in it. One, for a workforce to be productive, first they must know how to do things. They must have that knowledge. And that is something that this government is addressing through the various programs that we already have. We have the levy grant scheme that is in place, which compels all employees in Fiji to pay a levy of 1% of their gross payroll to the NTPC, and you have the opportunity to use that money to train your employees. I think that's one tool that we need to use much better, an investment in training. Government has already done a lot of investment in terms of training, in terms of the TOPA scheme, the TELS program, the education, the money that is being provided in that area. But it needs to be topped up by the work that is being done within individual enterprises. It is not possible for you to get somebody that comes out of an institution that knows exactly what you want that person to be able to do. It's just not possible. I think all companies need to have that system where they develop that knowledge. The other thing that is very important for somebody to be productive workforce is that they should not only know what that needs to be done, they should be able to do it. And I think here one of the important things that we have now is the role of the National Qualifications Framework and the Fiji Higher Education Commission that tries to establish national standards for different occupations in terms of competencies. There's a whole approach now to developing competencies and assessing against competencies. I think Mr. Arvind Maharaj is a part of that setup at FNU that tries to develop that. And that I think is going to be something that has to be, that all enterprises need to be involved with, this approach to competency-based learning. The third aspect of building a more productive workforce is the workers themselves must want to be more productive. It's all about attitude of mind. And I think one of the things that we are seeing now in terms of the reforms that you've seen at places like the ports, where the organization, they have been able to give out bonuses for people. I think that sort of approach is also something that you need, where workers can share in the productive benefits of what gets out of a company. When you have that investment, you will build that culture of increasing productivity. So it's not something that you can just do within government. You need to build that sort of a culture or a system where people can share the benefits of the profits that the companies make. Globally in the world today, productivity is increasing, but the share of that productivity that goes to labor is declining. That is one of the reasons that we have this big emphasis on social wage. So in terms of productivity, in the past we used to have the Fiji Productivity Charter. Fiji, the employers were part of this Productivity Charter where they were responsibilities that they're supposed to make. I'm thinking that this is something that we will have to relook at to revive the Productivity Charter, and also there have been some suggestions that we should set up a productivity commission that tries to look at the macro aspects of productivity. That is also an area that we'll be looking at. What's the next one there? Non-adherence to employment contracts. Is that it? I think the suggestion that you made, Dr. Ali, that we can have some discussion on this, I'm open to those discussions. The focus of the ministry is to try to be as fair as possible to workers and also to employers. At the end of the day, government knows, as you mentioned, it is the enterprises that are the engine of growth. We need to make sure that they are as successful as possible. You make a lot of money, but at the same time, we must make sure that there is social justice. I keep getting reports. This past week, the Prime Minister texted me a complaint about a company in Lambasa that keeps two sets of books. Companies are still doing this, and I hope that members of your organization are not those organizations that keep two different sets of books that shows the wages that people are being paid. But as a ministry, our requirement is to be impartial. Not to try to favor employers, not to try to favor the employees, but try to work for the benefit of all of them. Next role is to be re-examined. I agree with this. There's already been a cabinet decision on the role of the NEC. It is, there's a re-examination of the role of NEC. It will be part of the formulation of the National Employment Policy. We have now have enough, a draft National Employment Policy in place. It'll come out. It is being discussed by the members of the National Employment Center Board, and it will be brought out for consultations to stakeholders where you can also contribute on what you think we need to do in order to enhance employment. And part of that, key role of the National Employment Center will be looked at the development of that National Employment Center board. The quality of the workforce issues, upskilling and aligning the industry needs. Once again, I think we've got the good, we have the mechanisms in place. We have the mechanisms in place. I am a very strong believer in the role of the Fiji Higher Education Commission, the work of the National Qualifications Framework and all the mechanics around that. And I think those systems are already in place, but through dialogue and discussion, we can just try to improve the efficiency and the efficacy of the systems that we have already in place. So I'll just leave it there.
I try to keep it to 5 minutes.
There's more questions coming, Minister.
Okay.